Welcome to Memorial Stadium and the sea of red in the heartland of Lincoln, Nebraska. An uncommon place and home to an uncommon program with a championship pedigree. A Big Ten showdown is coming. Conference implications aplenty that could resonate for the rest of the season. As we'll see, the Rutgers Scarlet Knights taking on the Nebraska Cornhuskers. For EA Sports College Football, Reese Davis with you alongside David Pollack and Jesse Palmer. Time to get this game started. The Scarlet Knights will put toe to leather and will get started. He'll start the return inside his five. He was hoping for something a little more dynamic, but they get him on the ground at the 20. So the Nebraska Cornhuskers offense will start this game off. And here he is, guys. Anytime he takes the field, he is in complete control of this offense.
And David, he gives defensive coordinators nightmares because of his ability. They're going to have a hard time slowing him down.
No, he just doesn't have those weaknesses, those flaws, the whole playbook available, and he is a dude.
I'll say this, man. In college football, you see a lot of bad tackling. You didn't see it right there. That was an awesome job. First off, being there at the point of attack, once the tight end made the catch, there was no doubt he was going down. Great job, form tackle.
Trying to get a rhythm in the passing game. Now on second down. On the ground, it's Urban. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Listen, I know there are a lot of DBs out there that all they want to do is get interceptions and dance in the end zone. This dude likes to put his face in the fan, get close to the line of scrimmage, and tackle. And on the opening drive that he's out there, he gets a huge tackle for loss early. That is a statement play.
Back to pass, it's Rayola. Makes the catch, makes the grab, and it's enough for the first down before he's dragged to the ground. Really good throw and catch there, David, but on third down, you have to put a little bit of heat on the quarterback somehow.
Somehow, some way, get him uncomfortable. They didn't do it there. Great job by this offensive line. Nice protection, good clean pocket. QB rips the football, easily gets the first down.
The give to the back. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
How about the defender being a heat-seeking missile? He was on radar lock. He found the football and flew down with some bad intentions.
Lost one on that last one. It's second and 11. He's looking to throw. Hugs it downfield. Got his man downfield. Excellent job working through the air there, finding a hole in that defense and picking up a first down. This tight end just creates matchup problems no matter how you try to defend.
How about the catch radius on him, too? So as a quarterback, you don't have to be perfect when throwing it to him. You just got to get it somewhere in his vicinity, and he can come up with the catch.
From the gun, they'll try to impose their will. And a nice run there before the defense finally makes the stop.
Yeah, this coaching staff, they're getting this offensive line lathered up and into a rhythm. Now they're letting him drive off the ball on first down on these running plays, and they're getting chunks of yardage.
That kind of pickup on first down, and you can take a shot here on second and short. The give to the back. Just making a play, getting it to the 23-yard line. It'll be first down.
Well, when you talk Nebraska football, it always comes down to their ability running it on offense, whether it's the option or whether it's conventional. They've got a long and illustrious history of great running backs, and this guy is on the field for a reason. His vision, his ability to make people miss, run with toughness, he can do it all.
They make the stop, and this running game moves the chains as they get the first down.
You've got to be loving what you're seeing from your offense here on the opening drive of this game. They're in a really nice rhythm. They've got real good balance going on right now, and they've got the defense on their heels.
And the Huskers have it in scoring position on first and goal. They'll He'll try to get it in with the run. Forges ahead for one to the 8-yard line. Defense rose up deep in its own end on that last play. Now a second and long coming. Quick touch pass to the receiver. And a decent gain there before the defense makes a stop. They've controlled the ball on this opening drive. Play number 10 brings us to third and goal. Dropping back, it's Rayola getting some heat. Didn't have anything working and just had to throw it away on third down.
Got to give the defense credit on that play, taking everything away, forcing the incompletion. Now it's decision time, fourth and short, and you're in field goal range. What do you do here?
Looks as if they'll send out the field goal unit. From the left hash, this one shouldn't be too much trouble. Splits the uprights, it's good. And with that, they break the seal on the scoring. It's 3-0.
This is a team that really prides themselves on starting fast. We've seen that before, and here they are playing at home today. Nice job on the opening drive. Lots of poise, good emotion. They don't get the touchdown they would have liked, but they kick a nice field goal. They've got the lead. Head coach has to be happy with that.
So they were able to put up a 3-spot on that last drive, and now the kickoff team out there as they prepare to put boot to leather. And he hauls it in, and everybody's on the edge of their seats. And the returner will be brought down. The Scarlet Knights offense has its first opportunity of the day. As we take a look at our impact players for this game, David, what do you look for to make an impact from your leaders?
Your leaders not only have to lead the football team, but they got to step up and make plays on the field, keep everybody calm. These guys typically do a really good job of it.
Yeah, David, and they also generally set the tone for their respective football teams. Regardless of which side of the ball they play on, the teammates look towards them to step up in big games like this.
This crowd going to try to make life miserable for these guys. From the shotgun, the inside give. And they try the middle of this stout defense, and they rise to the challenge.
Defense is about firing off, hitting the offensive guys, and staying in your gaps, everybody knowing where they're supposed to be. You could tell the defense, everyone was right where they're supposed to be, nowhere to run.
Third and short, they've got them back up inside the 20, and the D can get the ball back here. From the gun, wants to pass. He finds his man. And he converts on third down as he gets it out to the 26.
Quarterbacks are just like anybody else. They get in rhythms. And to get in a rhythm early on third down and have a little success here and get the sticks moving, great chance to continue to get this offense moving down the field to get some more points.
And the Scarlet Knights getting set on first and 10. From the gun, to give, looking for room. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
They're trying to run the ball on first down, guys, but just nothing doing up front. Their offensive line got blown up on that play. There was nowhere for that guy to go.
Lost one on that last one. It's second and 11. They'll try it over the left side. Bowles his way forward. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Well, he was trying to do it all by himself. At the end of the day, it's a tackle for us.
The number of tackles he broke, at some point, somebody's got to get blocked to help the guy out a little bit.
Man, the defense was like a bunch of zombies on that last play. They just would not stop chasing that ball carrier.
On third and long, he's going to have to throw for it. They'll run the screen.
On a big third down, love the discipline by the defense there. You got everybody with their eyes on the quarterback, rallying to the football, showing good speed on D. Nice tackle. Love the team defense.
The Scarlet Knights will line up to punt it away. Getting our first look of the afternoon at the punter. Signals for the fair catch and hauls it in just shy of the 30. We've come to the end of the quarter and Nebraska is on top. We've put one in the books. Let's have a look at our game summary. Heading in the opposite directions now as we crank it up in the second. And here comes the Nebraska offense back onto the field. And to settle for the chip shot field goal last time, Jesse, they'd love for this one to pay off bigger.
Yeah, it just comes down to execution, too. Did a nice job out in the field, stalled a little bit once they got down to the goal line, so they just need to be a little bit more crisp here, Nick.
Yeah, and listen, I think the first part was the most important part. You got to put the drive together first to get down there. Now, when we get down there, focus on execution and getting 6 points.
After the productive first down play, it's second and six. To the air, it's Rayola. And he intercepts it. Didn't really have room to operate on the return, but he hands him the ball at the 32.
What a nice catch by the defensive back. Listen, a lot of times you see DBs get in position to make plays, but there's a reason they play DB and not wide receiver. Great job finishing the interception, catching the ball, making a big play.
Rutgers has it back. They'll send the offense back onto the field. After punting the last time they had it, they ought to be set up for a much better result with this drive.
This offense better be licking their chops. You're not going to start with better field possession than this all game did.
You ain't lying. Forget about the last possession and what we did. You're already in scoring position. Take care of that football. Make sure you get some points.
Just outside the red zone, first and 10 from the 21. They'll give it to him again. They'll pick up 4, second and 6 coming. And the Scarlet Knights are threatening in the red zone. On second down, he'll let it fly. He makes the catch in the end zone. Touchdown, Scarlet Knights.
One of the areas they really focused on with this receiver in the offseason was we need you to make more plays for us in the end zone. When we're taking shots, we need you to be able to step up and make tough catches. And David, what a grab right there.
And I think a lot of that has to do with trusting your guy, knowing where he's going to be, knowing when he's going to sit down, when he's not. So being on the same page and then having a guy that can go get it. Just when the ball is near him, he's going to make the play just like he did right there for 6 points.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And the extra point is good, and it's a 4-point lead. Quick strike offense on that 3-play scoring drive. And the score comes on a 17-yard throw for the touchdown. Just about set to kick it away. And here's the return. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. The Cornhuskers ready to go back to work on offense. After that last pick, David, they really need to take care of the ball this time.
No doubt. And Palmer, I want to know what Spurrier said to you on the sideline after a pick.
Do that again and you'll be right here beside me for the rest of the game. You got to go out. You got to call your plays. And I hope this coaching staff isn't going to be afraid to throw at this drive.
Now on second down. Looking to throw, it's Rayola. Makes a grab over the middle. And the defense stops him just short of the first down. Maybe needed a few more chain links to move the sticks. That big pickup on what they call the drag route, but if you hit it on time, you can hit the turbo boosters.
And you've got to be accurate on the throw too, Reese. Nice job by the QB there, putting it out in front of his receiver to make an easy catch and then advance it.
They're going to go to the air on third and short. Grab near the marker. It's Nayer. Good job running that route to get past the sticks because he got nothing after the catch. Third down, a lot of times it comes down to not necessarily who's the most open, Who do you trust the most?
No, it's not about the X's and the O's. It's about the Jimmies and the Joes. And when my guy's better than you and I get you matched up out wide and I know I trust you, I'm finding you.
And now move the chains and get it to the 47-yard line.
That's a great-looking run there. Nebraska's had such a great lineage at running back. When you think back to the great Roger Craig or Amon Green, Lawrence Phillips, Rex Burkhead, they always seem to be pumping somebody up into the NFL. This guy has a chance to play on Sunday because of his skills.
To the ground. He's got it again. And they'll shove him out of bounds after the short gain.
Offensive linemen love to run the power. Why? You run power. You run power. Then you can play action. You don't want that defense to be sitting there saying, it's a pass, it's a pass, having to pass block every play. You got to keep defenses off balance.
Halfway there on first down, it's 2nd and 5. From the gun, he leaves it with the back. There to stop him at the 43, but he gets 5 and moves the sticks.
And I don't care if I get it by 2, by 20, by 30, by 40. I just want to get the first down, understanding the situation, understanding where the sticks are. Doesn't have to be sexy, but I got to make sure I get to that stick, get to the first down mark.
Not the most productive half for this offense so far, but finally starting to get it in gear. 1st and 10. Crosses the 30, he's got away. And he was loose and in the open field and on his way. A tremendous pickup on that one.
Those outside runs, if they can get the edge like they do, great job by the right guard, right tackle, getting the edge. And now what does this do? This makes cornerbacks come up and tackle. Safeties come up and tackle. As opposed to linebackers and big defensive players, you get your guy out in space where he can use his speed and his...
Going for it all. And it was worth going for a chunk play, but the long pass is incomplete.
And that's just a huge missed opportunity on offense. QB missed his guy wide open in the end zone. You might not get another clean look like that in the rest of this game.
And the incompletion brings up a 2nd down. Off play action. He's got an open man. And the catch and run into the end zone. Touchdown, Husker!
Forget about those tight ends, right? They come up and they block most of the time and a lot of time near the line of scrimmage. And then occasionally offenses do a great job, get creative, find a way to get a good matchup for the tight end. And he does the rest and gets in for 6.
Lining up to tack one more onto that lead. And the extra point puts them up by a field goal. So an 82-yard drive there. And they finish it off with a touchdown toss from the 23. The kickoff unit about to go to work. Here he comes from inside his own 5. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. And the Rutgers offense heads back onto the field. From the gun, the ground game. Out across the 20 to the 21-yard line, a 3-yard gain.
And sticking to the run. I tell you what, a lot of teams that are really good are really stubborn, and they continue to run the football even with little success. So this offense is going to continue to focus on running the football, you can tell.
Got 3 on 1st down. It's 2nd and 7. From the shotgun, they'll run it. Stacked up after gaining a couple to the 23.
Man, that D-tackle is a freak athlete. Did you see him come out of his stance and beat the offensive lineman? Getting to the running back, cat-like quickness.
Decibels rising as the crowd gets behind this defense on 3rd down. From the gun, wants to pass. Throws to the tight end. It's caught downfield. And they reacted well to the completion, but it was too late to keep them from getting the 1st down.
Well, look, that wasn't a touchdown, but that was a massive play for this offense. They needed some momentum. They needed to find a rhythm, and what better way then converting on third down. Awesome job by the quarterback getting through his progression.
Touch pass on the jet sweep. The defense wouldn't let him loose there, and it was a completion, but they lost yardage.
Got to give the defense credit. Watching film, anticipating. They knew that this offense had this play in their back pocket. They knew about the speed of this wide receiver and different ways they were going to try to get him involved. Everybody on defense on the same page, playing together. I love it.
On second down, just keeps firing. They'll throw it to the back on the screen. And he goes out of bounds after a nice pickup on that one.
And he didn't get a big gain. You want to call that play and probably want to get more yards, but you could tell that was super close from seriously busting loose. Nice job running the screen, getting the ball to your playmaker. If he could just make one more guy miss, that might have been huge.
Looking to throw it again. And the quarterback is snowed under. Referee signals timeout. It's the defense wanting to make sure that they have everything just right with a big play coming. The Scarlet Knights decide to punt it away. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. No return coming. He'll call for the fair catch. Offense set on first down. They're going to open this drive with a pass. Unloads it downfield. Brings it down on the right side. And they'll finally bring him down after he rips off a huge play.
And you just could not allow that to happen defensively, giving up a big play like that. They're going to need to now play with some sense of urgency if they're not going to give up any points here before the end of the half.
The offense will put it in play from the 47 on first and 10. Fires to the wideout. And the physical play there forces the incompletion on first down. And here comes the offense on second down. Looking for a man, it's Rayola. Gonna take a shot. And it goes through his hands. Oh, he had an explosive play right there for the taking, but couldn't reel it in.
And the offense clearly saying, we want to take those deep shots. We want to be aggressive. And I think that's a good strategy because it makes the defense really honor what you're going to do. And just missed a little bit, but I wouldn't be surprised if this offense finds a way to come back to some of those deep ones.
Caught in the backfield. It's Banks. He's close to the first down, but they're going to mark him just a little short. And they'll pat the kicker on the tail and tell him to go give it a shot. He says he's got a big leg. He's going to have to show it from 56 yards out. No, no good. Guys, a missed opportunity there. The lead is still 3. Rutgers has it back. They'll send the offense back onto the field. David, the punter got some work last time. They'd like to keep him on the sidelines in this drive.
Yeah, and it's not something you want to say very often. You don't want the punter out there. This offense needs to get back lathered up and get a little bit more of a rhythm.
Best way to do that, identify where your best players are and just get them the football. Give these guys some touches to kickstart this offense.
The officials offer the deal and the coach accepts it. They will take the penalty. Looking to throw on second down. With the catch, it's Miller. There's a timeout called as this offense tries to find a way to draw a little closer. Here comes this home crowd as the defense tries to get off the field on third down. They'll try to get it through the air. Catch in the middle, it's Miller. We got a timeout here late in the first half, and they'll try to get more points on the board before the break. Offense threatening at the 45-yard line on first and 10. looking to move it through the air. Unloads it left. How about getting the foot down on that throw for the big completion?
And I love the awareness by the wide receiver on that play, because I'm not sure that route was supposed to be that deep. You got to wonder if the receiver decided maybe to adjust the route a little bit to make sure that he got the first down.
And the Scarlet Knights with the first and 10. He's going to pass. Can't hold on. He had it right down the middle, and he flat dropped it. Time dwindling away as they try to put points on the board right before the half. Couldn't connect on first down, now back to the air. Grab behind the line. It's Monaga. They'll use a timeout right before halftime. Maybe time for one or two more plays. Now with just a few seconds left, not enough time to run another play, but there is time to kick a field goal and take the lead. That is no good. And after the miss, they're still down by a field goal.
Well, that's one the kicker would like to have back. That's a kick he should be making in his sleep.
And with time running out here in the first half, this offense will choose to take a knee. As expected, they're content to run out the clock and go into halftime. That's going to wrap up the first half here, and now we join Kevin with a halftime update.
Guys, time for everyone to take a deep breath and digest what we just saw in Lincoln. And it's been said football is a game of inches, and guess what? Based on the comparison between third down conversion rate today and the average yard per play, how can you argue that? I mean, the low-lying fruit is to look at some of the explosive plays we've seen and panic. But really, this game is going to come down to which team is more efficient when they have the ball and how they play when it matters most. And with that, back to the Sea of Red and our guys at Memorial Stadium.
The Cornhuskers will kick it away to start the second half. And he takes this from inside the five. And he's able to pick his way through the traffic nicely for a good return on that one before he's brought down. They keep it on the ground to open the third. Nowhere to run on that one. He loses four on the carry. Well, the most insightful analysis I can come up with on that one is that didn't work. Back to the drawing board to see if there's something that works a little better soon.
Or if I can quote the great Reese Davis, that was very ungood. Not a productive first down play.
They'll go right back to it. Rumbles ahead for a pickup of 5 to the 29.
There's just so much for this defense to think about right now. They've had strong side runs thrown at them. Now the counter. They know that this offense can work in the play action off of all these base runs too. So much offensive volume this defense needs to worry about at this point in the game.
Third and long, and he'll try to throw for it. They're setting up the screen. Runs through a tackle. They play that screen nicely. He tried to find his way to the marker, but it'll be fourth down.
Love the execution there on the screen. The running back shows pass protect. Last second turns around, so he's able to get the ball. The D linemen have already run past him. Now he can turn upfield for a big gainer.
The Scarlet Knights will bring the punt team onto the field. He'll try to really get into this one. Fair catch called for and made. And here comes the Nebraska offense back onto the field. It has been a complete uphill struggle for both of these offenses, Jesse.
It sure has. At this point, David, someone's just going to have to step up and make a play. Someone's got to break a tackle, make an incredible catch, and just give some life to this offense.
And whatever you can, whatever it takes. Don't worry about looking pretty. That's out the window. We've already looked really, really ugly. We got to find something that works to put some points on the board.
They opened up this drive, getting all the way out to the 35, and now it's first down again. They'll ride the hot hand. Fakes his man out. and he's able to shed one tackle and pick up pretty good yardage.
This defense has got to get better at tackling in the open field or gang tackling, because if you need three or four guys to bring a guy down, have fun with that.
8-yard pickup on first down leaves them with second and short. Hand off from the shotgun. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple.
Well, there's just nowhere to go for the runner on that last play. Just way too much penetration up front. And as a result, they lose yardage.
Come to the line at the 42, facing a third and short. Looking to throw, it's Rayola. Oh, picked off. Going the other way, and he's got room. Touchdown, Scarlet Knights. A great return for the touchdown. Any return for a touchdown is a great one to a defense.
This guy really is the complete linebacker. Not only is he physical, and not only can he play downhill to stop the run, this guy is a weapon in pass coverage. You saw it on that play. What can't this guy do?
Getting set for the point after. And with the extra point, they're up 14-10. They're lining up to kick it off after the pick six, and that defense will come out feeling it. On the move from inside his five. He was hoping for something a little more dynamic, but they get him on the ground at the 20. The Cornhuskers ready to go back to work on offense. Here's the handoff. Knocked down after picking up five out to the 24.
It's the MO of this offense, and they really put a lot on the offensive line to go out and really try and establish their dominance and their assertiveness, and they've done a good job of that early in this game running the football.
Halfway there on first down, it's second and five. And he'll be brought down. Here they come, trying to convert a third and short from the 28. Wide receiver shows motion. Trying play action. That's caught. It's Irvin. He steps out of bounds, but he's got a first down on the play.
I don't always have to push the ball down the field. I love when QBs drop back, look at it, matchups. Oh, I got my running back. I think he can get the first down. Give him the football. Let him be an athlete with the football in his hands after he catches it. Nice job by the QB. Nice job by the running back.
He'll come out throwing on first down. Wide open downfield. Got a lot of running room. Defense makes a stop, but the chains move, and it's first and goal from the 8.
It's a beautiful pass and catch. I love the job the quarterback does manipulating the defense with his eyes. He froze that safety, and that allowed his receiver more room to work his route.
The Huskers have it in scoring position on first and goal. They'll try to get it in with the run. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one. That linebacker was a heat-seeking missile, and the heat that he sought was the ball carrier.
Yeah, great job, great feel. Linebackers are making all the calls in the defense and understanding when I need to come through that gap and come through with bad intentions. Those guys are usually 245 pounds of heat-seeking missile.
He makes a grab, and won't be able to get in as the defense gets him down at the one.
It's important on offense to get the tight ends involved in the passing game. These are big fellas that can run. This guy's a big target, so nice job on that play.
They'll come to the line just 1 yard shy of the goal line on third down. Powers forward. Touchdown, Nebraska! They take the lead with the 6.
And I love it. I love the physicality of this offense. It's third and goal. I trust my offensive line to pave the way, give the ball to my running back, and know he's going to physically punch this thing into the end zone.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And the extra point puts them up by a field goal. So a drive there of 82 yards, and they capped it off with a 1 yard plunge. Almost ready to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. Looking for those open spaces and opportunity. And the returner will be brought down. And the Rutgers offense heads back onto the field. Boy, 3 and out last time, David. They'd like to be more productive this time around.
Yeah, in the last drive, nothing really clicked. No rhythm, got off the field really, really quickly. They need to put something together here, opponent.
Yeah, David, bad execution on that last drive. So they got to take a collective breath and start playing like a unit on this drive.
This offense has a second down play. He's looking to throw. Caught close to the marker, it's Miller. Knocked down at the 31 after a gain of 5. It's 1st and 10 from the 31. They'll give it to the back. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple.
They're trying to run the football. There's just nowhere to go for the ball carrier inside. He tried to bounce it to the outside. That linebacker way too fast. He met him there and forced the TFL.
After losing a couple on that last play, here's 2nd and 12. He's looking to throw. They're bringing heat. They get enough rush, and it pays off. The sack at the 20. We've come to the end of the quarter, and Nebraska is on top. They've done the work to build a nice cushion. Now to bring it home as we check out the stats after 3 quarters. One more period to go to see who can make the winning plays and come home with the victory. And we might as well state the obvious. 1st and 2nd down didn't work out. 3rd and very long. He'll loft one deep down the left side. And he'll pull it in inside the 20. Touchdown, Rutgers. They've got the lead here in the 4th.
Yeah, and a nice job in the 4th quarter making plays, and a nice job being on the same page. QB, receiver. You could tell he broke with the football. He caught it in stride, gets into the end zone. Nice pitch and catch right there. Nice chemistry by the QB and wide receiver.
Now they'll line up for what they hope is automatic. And the extra point is good, and every point counts. It's now a 4-point lead in the 4th. About to kick it off after punching it in for the touchdown. And he's going to bring it out of the end zone. Not nearly as much as he'd hoped when he brought it out of the end zone. He'll be stopped at the 15. And here comes the Nebraska offense back onto the field. And he makes the catch, but he can't stay in bounds. That'll be incomplete. Offense gets set for second down. They'll try the run. They needed to find enough space and get it moving forward, and they're up to the 22.
Listen, you got to be able to know what play to call and what hole to go through. Like, the line blocks for a certain hole. Good job getting through the hole, getting what was blocked, getting a nice positive gain, making your situation really good on the next down.
Here on third down for this offense. Looking to throw for it. Catch in the middle. It's Coleman. That's the kind of play that can really get you going as they get it out to the 36.
That's tough on the defense there. Third down, you're in zone coverage. Everybody's watching the quarterback, and you're trying to make a break on the ball, but he just got it out of his hands too quickly, and the throw was too accurate. Really nothing you can do there, and it's now a fresh set of downs.
Looking for space. It's Irvin.
That's a really good job by the defense, wrapping them up, getting them on the ground. Take away that run game. Make them one-dimensional, put them in passing situations. Really good job by the defense.
After picking up a couple, it's second and eight. They'll put the tight end in motion. Out of the shotgun, they go to the ground. Really nice stop there from this senior leader. Ball is at the 42-yard line, close to four-down territory. Here's third and short. Gives it to the back on the draw. He's got first down yardage across the 50. They'll mark it at the 49.
And they just kind of sneaked that one in there. As a defensive guy, third and five plus, I'm thinking pass. They were thinking pass, Palmer, and they slipped the run in.
And it's so nice then to have this guy at running back too, right? Because you could throw it to him on third down or hand it off. And he's got the vision and the athleticism to go pick up that first, keep the drive going.
On the ground with the counter. And he's able to find a little bit of running room before they get him down.
They showed this run in the first half, right? You saw it. They loaded up on this side, ran the football, had some success. What do they do in the second half? Pull some guys, run the counter the other direction to keep the defense off balance.
Good spot after that 7-yard pickup on first down. It's second and three. Grab behind the line. It's Fadone. They make the stop, but the sweet pulling catch is plenty to give them a first down.
Nice job decision-making by the quarterback there in the RPO, not handing it off, knowing he had to throw it, but then also understanding his open guy was going to be in the right flat.
And the Huskers have it with a first and 10. He's looking to throw it. Pocket starts to collapse. Good job to avoid the negative play and just get rid of that thing. Here comes the offense on second down. Back to throw, it's Rayola. Got the back over the middle.
Well, look, this quarterback has struggled a little bit in this game with interceptions. Maybe he was being too greedy early on. That time made a real good decision. And I'll tell you what, that's a nice catch by the running back because that ball's in the air a long time. You're throwing it all the way out to the flat like that. He looked like a receiver making that catch and getting extra yards.
Third and short from the 22. Is the field goal unit getting ready, or is this already four-down territory? It's complete to the left. Touchdown, Cornhuskers! And they grab the advantage, taking the lead here in the fourth.
I think one of the most underrated things we talk about with a QB is timing. Being able to get the ball out of his hands to his receiver where he can continue to catch the football and run with it. Nice pitch, nice catch, nice play in the fourth quarter when you needed it for this team to take the lead.
This one's big to make sure they can't beat you with a field goal. And it's good, and he's got the lead up to three late. So a drive there of 85 yards, and the scoring play comes on a touchdown pass from 22 yards out. The kickoff team on the field as they'll send this one away. He'll bring it back from inside his five. Nice job by the kickoff team. Everybody stayed in their lanes, and they'll stop him at the 16. Rutgers has it back. They'll send the offense back onto the field. Now they need to put something together to answer that last score.
There's a lot of pressure, too, on this offense to have to execute at a high level. They've got to score points, David, but they can't go too fast because their defense right now is tired.
And I think that's the difficulty being a play caller. Like, I have to balance all of those things. My defense is a little bit tired. I can't put on the field, but I got to be aggressive because this is a back-and-forth type game, so a lot to process and think about.
You open a drive like that, and you've got some operating room. It's first down from the 38. Nowhere to go, and the ball is loose.
Woo. Deep breath, right? Man, you fumble that thing, you cough it up, you're like, oh, I really appreciate you, brother. I can't tell you how much I thank you because the coaches would have been all over me, but big-time break for the offense.
Second down after the offense averted absolute disaster. He's looking to throw. And the pass is incomplete thanks to a big hit. Better find the earplugs. Here comes the noise, backing this defense on third down. Looking to throw, and he needs a bunch. He lofts it high and deep down the left side. And it's caught inside the 25. And they'll do more than move the chains. They'll move that thing more than 30 yards down the field before he's finally stopped.
What a beautiful throw and catch on this play. And I love the job the receiver did tracking the ball in the air. Nice job of locating the throw and then hauling it in.
And the Scarlet Knights are rolling down the field. Looking to go up top on first down.
Got it!
And he goes out of bounds after coming up with positive yardage there.
And you see so many smart wide receivers, so many smart tight ends nowadays that they know where the holes in those zones are, and they work with their quarterback, and they find them, and they sit down in them and make big plays. It's tough to sit back in zone against such smart players nowadays.
He wants to throw here on second down. Touchdown, Rutgers! They move on top here in the fourth. That's his third touchdown pass of the day. The defense has no clue how to respond right now.
No, and the defense has had absolutely no answer. He's been on the money, he's been on fire, making the right decisions and just carving this defense up.
Lining up to tack one more onto that lead. And the extra point is good, and every point counts. It's now a 4-point lead in the fourth. About to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. on the run from inside his own five. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. The Cornhuskers ready to go back to work on offense. He'll start this drive firing. And a little too much adrenaline on that throw never gave his receiver a chance. They'll try again on second down after the incompletion. He'll try to pop the draw. And a good solid pickup there before the defense knocks him down.
Draws and screens are a great way to slow down really aggressive pass rushers. It allows the defensive ends and the defensive tackles to run upfield. The offensive linemen kind of push them upfield, go down to the next level, try to sneak in a big play.
Still plenty of time for this offense, but this probably their final drive under 2 minutes to play. Wants to throw. It's Raiola. Throws to the wideout. Finds a man in the middle. He's there to make the stop, but the damage has been done as they pick up the first down on the throw and catch. This dude is just exceptional in every facet. So fluid, such a great route runner, and a big play there.
And money down, third down, find him. I mean, you want to find that matchup because he's going to win and gets a good release, gets down the field. You see his, that's your playmaker, that's your guy. Get it to him, get the first down.
Great job in this two-minute drill as he gets out of bounds, keeping the clock on their side as they're trying to pull it out. The Cornhuskers come to the line with a new set of downs. Going up top on first down. They've got the screen set up. Open space at the 25. And he gets out of bounds to stop the clock as the offense moves closer, trying to pull it out. He knew exactly what they needed there, made the play, and got out of bounds to stop the clock.
And you got to keep this turbo mode on, right? We got to keep going fast. The clock's running down. Fourth quarter, need a score. Great execution to get the first down. We need a lot more of this on this drive.
Trying to cap this drive with the pass. Caught behind the line. It's Mayer. They're able to keep him out of the end zone. He'll be stopped at the two after the big play in the passing game. The offense gets a quick timeout at this point. Every second is precious. So now the opportunity with a touchdown to take the lead. Slams it ahead. He pushes it forward all the way to the 2 yard line. We'll see if the offense can punch it in on second and goal. Now the play fake. Fires into the end zone. It falls incomplete. He was trying to find his man for six.
Yeah, and at this point of the game, guys, fourth quarter, you're trailing. You know that they're going to be throwing the ball and trying to be aggressive and try to climb back into this one. Couldn't come up with it there on second down. Let's see what happens on third.
Trying to pick up a first down. They'll try to pass it in on third and goal. Couldn't find a man and just had to throw it away to avoid a negative play.
And if you're the defense right now, you've given up some yards on this drive, but you've got a possession lead. You just need one more stop after that last incompletion setting up fourth down. Do you blitz? Do you try to speed up the QB? Let's find out and watch.
Down in the final period in a tight game, and they will go for it on fourth. Touchdown, Husker! And in the final moments, they've taken the lead.
Man, I love this offense, being able to run the football late in the game when it matters and punch it in for the touchdown, and more importantly, take the lead.
Needs this one to push the lead to a field goal. And it's good, and he pushes the lead to three. So an 82-yard drive there. And what a late touchdown in the final minute that is likely the game winner here. They're lining up to boot it away. He'll start the return inside his five. And the return man reaches the end of the line, and down he goes. And the Rutgers offense heads back onto the field. After standing on the sideline and watching that long touchdown drive, they really need to put something together to give their defense a rest.
And that's a real thing, man. Like, you played a lot of plays, you get worn out, you need a chance to go decompress on the sideline, get some oxygen. Palmer, now it's on this offense.
Yeah, this is the definition of complementary football, because it's a two-pronged problem. You've got to score points and answer, but you've also got to take your time and give your defense an opportunity to get their win.
Quick timeout call by the offense after the play, trying to preserve every minute possible. Got to get everybody lined up quickly. Time winding away, and they've got to push the ball down the field. Trying to get to him. Just gets rid of it before the heat. Hit hard as he released the ball on that first down pass, and it never had a chance.
And the quarterback gets hit again. We already know this defense has gotten home to him multiple times in this game. So here you are. You're trailing in the game. Defense knows you're going to throw it. They're pinning their ears back. You can't feel very confident right now through the play caller and certainly through the quarterback that you're going to have time to throw.
Dumps it to the back. Grabbed over the middle. It's Monaga. They'll get him stopped at the 45, but it's a big 15-yard pickup and a first down. And now a fresh set of downs for this offense. Comes out throwing on first down. The quick out. And he laid the lumber to stop him from getting the first down.
Well, we've seen this guy come up with some huge throws in this game. And already on the drive, he's thrown a couple of completions. He's got them in a rhythm. This team believes they're going to win this game because of this guy playing the quarterback position.
The Scarlet Knights come to the line in the hurry up. A huge pressurized kick coming right now as this game hangs in the balance. They'll use the timeout, 6 seconds left on the clock. And this to tie things up in the final minute. They'll try to cap off this drive with a field goal. He got it. And they tie it up, fellas, here in the final second.
Wow, and with that field goal with so little time left here in the game, it looks like this thing's going to OT. You have to give that young guy so much credit. He had the weight of the world on his shoulders, and he's able to knock it through. We've still got some football left here, fellas.
Coming down the stretch in the fourth, and we are all tied up, about set to kick it away. Here he comes from inside his own five. And the returner will be dragged down. Well, guys, let's play some more. Headed to overtime.
And this just feels right. Both of these teams going back and forth. So, of course, David, this thing needs to get decided in OT.
Let's see who's better. Short amount of time to do it. A couple possessions probably. Maybe one possession each. Who's the better team?
All right, guys, so here we go in overtime, and just to refresh everyone's memory, alternating possessions starting on the opponent's 25.
And you want to play defense first because you want to know what you need. That's a key philosophical approach for most teams when it comes to overtime, David.
Yeah, and remember the rule change a couple years ago, too, and the second overtime and two-point conversion. So all this stuff is situational-type football that you better have worked on throughout these weeks of the season.
First play of the first possession of OT. Looking for a crease. It's Irvin. They finally make the stop, but the big run is plenty to move those sticks for the first down. Here comes first and goal as they try to strike here in overtime. Scanning the field, it's Rayola. Let's it go to the end zone. Touchdown, Nebraska! They take the lead here in overtime. like a Thanksgiving turkey. They're just being carved. No shot. They have no idea how to get in this quarterback's head.
He's on fire. Everything he's doing is working defensively. We got to figure something out. We got to try to do something a little bit different. Bring more pressure. At this rate, shoot, he's on so much fire, you might as well just send everybody. Blitz everybody, live for the results, because everything else ain't working anyways.
Now to push the lead to 7 in overtime. And the extra point is true, and they're on top by 7. They know what's in front of them. They have to answer that score with a touchdown. Trying to start the drive with a pass. Not much of a chance there. He just had to get rid of it to avoid the sack. After the incompletion, they're facing a 2nd and 10 from the 25. Misfired on the last play. They'll go back to the air. This time, it's complete. They make the stop right there. Good pickup. It's still short of the first down. Third down, and they need a touchdown to stay in the game. On 3rd and short, they'll ride the running back here. That run epitomizes a veteran, savvy senior who knows how to find space. First and goal in overtime, and they have to answer with a touchdown. He's looking to throw. They're trying to get to him. Caught in the backfield, it's Munaga. That completion will take it inside the 4, and the offense is threatening. These fans raising the volume on 2nd and goal. He's looking to throw. Going for 6. Touchdown, State University of New Jersey. They got the score. Now to see if they go for the win or the tie.
Obviously, very hard to complete passes this area of the field. Nice execution. Now you're down by 1, and now you got to make the decision. Are we going to go for it and try to end the game right here and put this game in our offense's hands? What do you think?
And that's why I love having the ball second, because I get the opportunity to do this. I knew they scored a touchdown. We scored a touchdown. Now, do I want to go for the win, or do I want to continue this game on? It's so nice to have the ball second.
Don't assume on this extra point. They needed to send it to a 2nd OT. And the extra point is good. One extra period, didn't get it done, and we start the 2nd OT. Off the play fake on 1st down. Makes his connection. And gang tackling on this dude is a good idea. They needed it, but he still got the 1st down. This thing has been back and forth now. 1st and goal as they try to take the lead in overtime number 2. With the run on 1st and goal. Touchdown, Scarlet Knights! That score gives them the lead here in the 2nd overtime. Precision blocking up front created the open lane, and the running back followed it beautifully.
Yeah, it's pretty easy to follow an offensive line that makes those holes and just gives you a caravan all the way to the end zone. What an unbelievable job blocking up front.
Second overtime, and they'll have to go for 2. trying to bully their way in. They do not get the two, and now the lead sits at six in double OT. Now on first down, they need to answer with a touchdown. They'll crank up this drive with the pass. Coming after it. And that's just a flat misfire, not even close to his receiver. Couldn't make the connection on first down. Now here on second. Back to throw. It's Raiola. Fires toward the end zone. Touchdown, Cornhuskers! They got it in to tie it up here in double overtime, and now the two-pointer will win it.
I think the quarterback showed his head coach a lot on that last touchdown pass, the poise and the confidence. And because of that, David, on this upcoming two-point play, you might just put it back in his hands and let him go win it for
you. Yeah, man, I need it again, right? Like, these rules, I got to go for two. This is a clutch moment, obviously. Got to come up big. Do you trust him again? You worked on these two-point plays all year long, all week long. That's what you do. You know the rules. Now you got to go execute.
Have to go for two, starting in double overtime, and this one would win the game. The snap sets up the throw. They are in! Ball game, and that does it in double OT with a two-point conversion.